Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can create a basic user information command that will allow you to tag a user or specify yourself, and it'll tell you some information about the user. Now this is a useful command to know because we are going to be taking a look through the documentation, and it's going to give you an example of how you can find useful information within the documentation for your own use cases. So a quick demo of this: if I go into my tutorial channel, I can run exclamation point user info. I also have to make sure I start my bot. So I can run this command, and it's going to display some user info about me. So it's going to say my name here. It's going to have my profile picture. It's going to have my user tag, if I'm a bot, my nickname in the Discord, which I don't have any, when I joined this Discord server, when I created a Discord account, and how many roles I have. I can also tag a specific user. So I can say exclamation point user info, and then @tutorial, for example. And so now this is going to display some basic information about the tutorial user. And so this is what we're going to be building in today's video. So going into VS Code, here I have this basic project. You can find a link to this in the GitHub repository, which can be found in the video description. And real quick before we start, if you do need help with anything, feel free to leave a comment down below or ask in the Warren Off Keys Discord server, and I'm sure someone will be able to help you there. So with that said, let's get started. So I'm going to go inside of my commands directory. I am using the Commando framework. A link to how to set that up will be in the video description. If you're comfortable with another command system, you can use that as well. So here I'm going to go inside the MISC folder, and I'm going to make a new file. This will be called user-info.js. And within here, we have to first import Commando. So I'm going to say constant Commando with a capital C, because this is going to be a class that we're importing. And we are going to require discord.js-commando. Now we're going to export a class, so we have to say module.exports. This is going to be a class called user info command, and this class is going to extend the functionality of commando.command. And so now we inherit all the functionality from that class that commando provides for us. Now we can use a constructor function, which is going to be ran whenever this class is initialized or whenever it's used within an object. This is going to have one argument, which is the client. And then from here, we're going to be able to call the constructor function for the command class. To do that, we have to call the super function. We have to then pass in the client that we are provided from our constructor. And then we can provide a second argument. Now this argument is going to be some information about the actual command, such as the name, which will be user info, the group, which will be MISC, because we are inside of the MISC folder over here. We could then have the member name, which will also be user info. And then we can have a description, which is going to be displays information about a user. Obviously, you can add in whatever you want there. Now at this point, we are going to have a function here. This is going to be an async function called run. So I can say run equals an asynchronous function. And this is going to be the command, or the function rather, that is ran whenever someone runs our command. So within here, we need to have access to the message, which is going to be a message object. Now we need to access the guild and the channel properties from the message object. We're going to be using those later on, so we can destructure those. So constant guild and channel. This is going to give us access to those from the message object. And then at this point, we want to gain access to the user. So we're going to use the user that the person tagged within running this command. And if they did not tag anyone, we are going to use that user who ran the command as the user. So I can say constant user. I can then say this equals message.mentions, which is going to be a list of different mentions, whether it's going to be channels or if it's going to be users. So we want to access the users, so we can say .users and then .first, which is going to get the first mention from the message. Now, if this doesn't exist, that means that this is going to be a falsy value. So we can use an OR statement here, which is going to say if this is a falsy value, then use whatever is to the right of the OR statement. And so we can simply just say message.member. User. Now that we have access to the user, which is going to be a Discord user, no matter which guild they are in, we're going to have certain information about this, but we want to have access to a guild member object, which is going to be similar to the user, but contain information regarding that person's status within the guild, such as what roles they have and things like that. So I'm going to say constant member equals guild.members.cache.git, and we can pass in an ID here. So user.id. So technically we do have access to the member already if the user didn't tag anyone, but this is the cleanest way to write the code. So I'm going to opt in for simplicity here. Either way, we are going to fetch the member from the guild, which isn't really going to take too long at all. So from this point, we have access to the user and we have access to the member. So I can go into the Discord documentation with discord.js.org, and I can click on documentation right here. If you guys ever are confused on anything, feel free to check this first before asking anywhere. This is probably going to solve most of your problems. So over here on classes, if we scroll down, we see guild member. I can click on this and we see a number of different properties and methods, and we're going to access some of these. Now, again, the guild member is a user that is inside of a guild. Here we see this user object, and I'm going to open this in a new tab. And this user is regarding to the specific Discord user, like their account, essentially. So we can click on type of user to see the class for that. And here we see some information. Now notice how we don't see roles or anything like that. We don't see kickable or the ability to kick them or anything like that. That's because this class is referring to the actual Discord account, where a guild member class does have ban and kick and things like that, because this is referring to the user within a specific Discord server. So we're going to access some different properties on both of these classes. But first, I want to go ahead and send an embed. So going back into my code here, I can import message embed from Discord.js. So constant, I'm going to have an empty object, and this is going to require Discord.js. Now within this object, I can say message embed. So I'm going to destructure it from the import here. So now we have access to message embeds. And then at this point, I'm going to create an embed. So I can say constant embed equals new message embed. And then I can chain some functions together, such as set author, which is going to have two parameters. The first one is going to be a string. The second one is going to be the URL for an image to use. So I'm going to use a template literal here for the string. And inside, I'm going to say user info for, and then I'm going to insert in user.username. Now we could take a look at the documentation to get more information on this. If I go to the user class, we see username right here. If I click on it, we see the username of the user. And so this is going to be the actual username, which is essentially going to be what we see on Discord, but without the actual numbers. So now going back into VS Code, we could then add in our second argument. And this is going to be the URL of the profile picture. So I can say user.displayAvatarURL. And this is going to be a function I'm going to call this. And again, the reason why I know this is because I checked the documentation for a user. If I scroll up to the top, we see right here displayAvatarURL. If I click on that, we see that this is a function that is going to return the actual avatar. So I can then go ahead and save this. And we're going to test this out real quick. So we already destructured the channel on line 15 here. So we can simply say channel.send, and we can pass in our embed. So I'm going to go ahead and save this, and I'm going to run my bot with node index.js. I can then go into Discord and I can run exclamation point user info, and it'll then say user info for Alexander Flores. I can then run user info at tutorial, and it'll say user info for tutorial. And as you can see, the profile pictures and the username here are going to be depending on if we tagged someone or if we didn't. Now going back to our code, we're going to add some more things to our embed here. So at the bottom right here, after our set author call, I'm going to say .addFields, and this is going to take in a number of different objects. So each object is going to have a name property and a value property. So we can specify the name, such as the user tag, and then I can access user.tag. This is going to be the username plus the numbers at the end. And again, this is in the documentation, and that's how I know that that exists. And then I'm going to add in a second object. Now, of course, we have to have a comma after each object here. The second object is going to have a name. This name is going to be isBot, and the value is going to be user.bot. Now, if I look in the documentation for the actual user, we see this bot property. If I click on it, it's a Boolean, which means it's a true or false value, whether or not the user is a bot. And so this is how we are going to determine if the user is a bot. Next, we're going to display the nickname. Now, this is going to be something where we need to access the guild member object, because this is going to be the nickname within the Discord server that we are in right now, or within the guild rather, which is the same thing as a server. So I can say name is nickname. And then the value is going to be from the actual guild member class. Here we see nickname right down here. I can click on this and it says the nickname of the member if they have one. Now we notice that there's a type here that has a question mark. So this is a string, but the question mark means it's not guaranteed to be there. It might be null or undefined or something like that. And so with that said, we have to keep that in mind. So the value can be member.nickname. Now, if this doesn't exist, for example, I don't have a nickname within my own Discord, so that is going to be a null value. And so we can use an OR statement, which is saying if the thing to the left of the OR statement is a falsy value, which null is, then it's going to use the thing to the right of the statement. And so I can just simply say none. So if there is no nickname, we're just going to simply say none. Next, we're going to say whenever this user joined the Discord server. So we can say the name is joined server, and then the value is going to be a new date, because we're going to format a timestamp, which is just a giant number, and we're going to format this into an actual date. So within new date, we have to pass in a parameter here, and that's going to be member.joined timestamp. And again, the reason why I know this is because of the documentation. If I go back into guild member and I go all the way up to the top, we can then find joined timestamp right here. This is going to be a number, the timestamp the member joined the guild at. And so now I can access this, and to convert this into an actual date, if we scroll up here, we see that these are actual dates. We can then use a function called toLocalDateString. So I can save this, and we're going to add a couple more things before we test again. So the next thing is going to be joined Discord, and this is going to be whenever the account was actually made. So the value is going to be very similar. We're going to create a new date, and we're going to say .toLocalDateString. But within the argument here, we're going to use a different value. This is going to be user.createdTimestamp. Now, the reason why we're using user here is because whenever the account was created is not relevant to any specific Discord server that we're within. And I also know that it exists because, of course, I checked the documentation. So if we go up here, we see under properties, created timestamp. If we click on this, we see it's a number, the timestamp the user was created at. Now, keep in mind that there's no question mark here. That means that this is guaranteed to be in the object, which makes sense because if the user actually exists, if it's something we're working with, and of course they have created a Discord account. So going back, we now have whenever they join the server and whenever they join Discord. And now we're going to count how many roles the user has. So the name can be role count, and the value is going to be member, because this is related to the actual Discord member, not the user itself, because this is within the Discord that we are in. So we have to use Discord member. So member.roles.cache.size. Now, this is going to include the default at everyone role, so we do want to subtract one from this. So if someone had zero custom roles that you added to your server, it would say one, just because everyone has one by default. If you want to include that, feel free to remove the negative one here, but I'm going to say minus one, and you'll see the difference here in a second. So I'm going to save this and run the bot with a node index.js. Going back in the Discord, I can then run exclamation point user info, and it's going to display some information. Here we see role count is 6, and if I click on my user, we see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, if I go back and I run exclamation point user info at tutorial, we see the role count is 3. If I click on tutorial, we see 3 roles. So the at everyone role, which isn't listed here, is going to be counted, and so you can subtract one if you want. And then we also see whenever the Discord account was created, and also whenever this person joined the Discord server. Here I have a nickname of none. And here we say isBot is false for my user, but whenever we're tagging tutorial, it says isBot is true. And so this is how you're going to create a basic user info command using Discord.js and the Commando framework. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.